Photorespiration. The plants normally go for photosynthesis. During the photosynthesis, the carbon dioxide is reduced into carbohydrates and the oxygen is released. Can you know the plant use and utilize the O2 and they releases the carbon dioxide also? In what condition? When CO2 is less at atmosphere, on that condition they go for photorespiration. So it explained as, first we wanted to know about the activity of Rubisco enzyme. In C3 cycle, RuBP take the CO2 and it produces the PGA in the presence of RuBP carboxylase and oxygen, is also called as Rubisco enzyme. What is this Rubisco enzyme? The Rubisco enzyme play dual role. One role is carboxylation. Carboxylation as carboxylase. Next, oxygenation as oxygenase. It showed dual role. In what condition it played dual role means, at normal atmosphere, when the concentration of CO2 is 0.03 and the concentration of oxygen is 21%. Normal. So normal composition of O2 and CO2 in atmospheric air. In this condition, it go for work as carboxylase enzyme. It means no disturbance for the C3 cycle carrying. Okay, but when CO2 availability is less than 0.3, and when more oxygen is available, on that condition it go and act as oxygenase enzyme. It means the low concentration of carbon dioxide promotes the Rubisco enzyme as Rubisco oxygenase, that conducted in photorespiration. What happened in photorespiration? In photorespiration, the plants absorb O2 and they release the CO2. They release the CO2. The released CO2 is utilized for PCR cycle, that is C3 cycle. What are the steps are involved? Why it is needed? So when the carbon dioxide concentration is less, to maintain the proper carbon dioxide concentration, here the photorespiration is carried out. And the reactions are mediated between the three organelles. It is a coordination of three organelles. What are the three organelles? Chloroplast, peroxisomes and mitochondria. In the presence of the light, the plants absorb the oxygen and they releases the carbon dioxide. Here, no ATP is synthesized, no starch is synthesized. So it is waste process for the plant. But the C3 plants do not escape from the photorespiration. So the photorespiration phenomena is common to the C3 plants. Here the photorespiration, that is the coordination work of three organelles. They are chloroplast, peroxisomes and mitochondria. Here the stable compound formed means, that is glycolate. The glycolate consists of two carbon molecules, hence it is said as C2 cycle and also said as glycolate pathway. You see here, the Rubisco enzyme, when the oxygen availability is more, then that condition it involves into the photorespiration. The first step of the C2 cycle happened in chloroplast. You see here, generally the RUBP is involved in the PCR cycle, that is common way. But here in the exception, when the oxygen concentration is more, the RUBP react with oxygen to produce the glycolate as well as 2-PGA. It means two molecules are produced, one is phosphoglycolate, another one is 2-PGA. The released 2-PGA is again involved in C3 cycle. And P-glycolate, that is phosphoglycolate, by losing one pyrophosphate, it turns into the glycolate. So the glycolate are the first stable compound formed in C2 cycle. Hence the cycle is said as glycolate pathway, also said as C2 cycle. And here the glycolate, formed glycolate is translocated into peroxisome. There it turns into the glycine. So the formed glycine again entered into the mitochondria. Here the major reactions are carried out. The major reactions are decarboxylation and deamination. So decarboxylation and deamination resulted to the production of serine from glycine. So the produced serine is again entered into the peroxisome. There it turned into the glycerate, and the formed glycerate are again entered into the chloroplast. There they involve in the production of PGA, phosphoglyceric acid. So the phosphoglyceric acid is the first intermediate compound for C3 cycle. So from there the C3 cycle is carried out. You see here, overall reactions, overall pathway, no ATP or no NADPH2 is released. No ATP and no NADPH. It means there is no releasing of energy. And is there any starch produced? No. No starch production. No starch production. But here, the carbon dioxide is released. Okay. It means to maintain, to increase the concentration of the carbon dioxide in the photosynthetic apparatus, here it is carried out. But in C4 plants, the photorespiration is absent. Why? Why means in the bundle sheath cells, the decarboxylation reaction is carried out. The reaction from malic acid to pyruvic acid production. It means C4 acids are turned into the C3 acid. During that phase, the carbon dioxide is released. The released carbon dioxide is used for the C3 cycle there. So there is no again reproduction of the CO2. Already the availability of CO2 is more in bundle sheath cells of the C4 cycle. Hence the C4 plants are escaped from the photorespiration.